Hello students, today we are going to see this topic, Python program execution, executing C++ program using control statements. Okay, so now in this chapter we are seeing this whole thing with importing C++ program into Python program. Okay, so in this topic we are going to create a C++ program, and that C++ program will be having some control statements, and that C++ program will be executed by a Python program. So here you can see some steps that has to be followed when combining to a programming language. Okay, type the C++ program to check whether the input number is palindrome or not in a notepad and save it as file name. Okay, type the Python program, step 2. Okay, type the Python program and save it as this file name. Click the run terminal and open the command window. Go to the folder of Python using cmd file. Type the command Python Python program file name hyphen I. Okay, hyphen I is a mode. Okay, PLI, and then the C++ program without the extension. Okay, file name of a C++ program without the extension of it. So here you can see that this is the C++ program, so which gets inputs from the user and makes the reverse of it. Okay, so it will change the first character into last character, and all the characters will be changed, and check whether both are the same. Okay, so if it is same, then it will return you this is a palindrome. If it not same, then it is not a palindrome. Now we are creating a Python program which gets all the instruction from the C++ program and execute it, and gives the output of it. Okay, so here you can see that it imports sys, os and getop files, diff main dot arguments. Okay, so since we are using C++ program, main dot argument is necessary. The C++ file, it's an empty variable. Executable file, it's an empty variable. Op and arguments, get op dot arguments. Okay, if any inputs has to be given, it will get it from you. Then for o comma a in ops. Okay, so this will read all the entire lines of codes, so it's given as for loop. Now define run. Okay, so this will compile and run the program. Okay, now you can see that program start executing from here. Okay, so if name is equal to name, then start. Okay, so main dot system dot argument is equal to 1. So here you can see that you can clearly view the output of it. Okay, so how next topic is how Python is handling the errors in C++. So sometimes you would have written some codes wrong. Okay, so C++ will show you some errors. So how the Python gets all this error and show it to you? Okay, Python not only executes the successful C++ program, it is also help to display even errors. If any C++ statement during the compilation, for example, in the following C++ program, an error is there. Okay, let us see what happens when you compile through Python. Okay, so here it is a small program. So here you can see that there is no semicolon at the end of std count hello. Okay, so this is the error here, and here you can see that it is now compiled with a Python program, and here you can see that it is showing the exact error at the output. Okay, so how it finds. Okay, so let's see here. Okay, in the above program, Python helps to display the error in C++. The error is displayed along with the with its line number. The line number starts with the line number starts from Python script. Okay, so here you can see that the Python script is also added here, and you can see that it is displaying the number of codes along with the line number. Okay, so next example, next topic is Python program executing C++ program containing array. Okay, so first example is C++ program containing control statements, then containing errors, now containing arrays. Okay, so with this you can see that this program will get the array and find the transpose of it. Okay, so here also the same options are used. So you can see this is the output of this program. So you would be noticing that Python program used to execute the transpose of a matrix is also the same as what you use in palindrome program. From this, what you have to understand is the Python script in this chapter is mainly used to read the C++ file along with the type of mode used, like I or O. So I means input, output, O means output. Okay, it parses means splits each value of the command line and passes as an argument to the list called ops, OPTS. Okay, so the entire C++ code is referred for reading by long ops I file on long option I files along with the mode. So the list O in for loop contains the mode IE, and the variable A contains C++ file with its complete path. The extension like cpp, exe are added by the Python script. Name variable directs the program to start from the Python script main. The main definition. The main definition does the parsing and adding the extension. The run defines. Run definition invokes the G++. G++ is the compiler. So compile and creates the exe file. The system commands of OS module executes the exe file, and you can get the desired output. The file extension are added by the Python script due to which you can even execute the C++ program. So by this you can understand what is happening at the background when you use C++ program with the help of Python program. Okay, so all the things is running at the background to ensure that you are getting the C++ program executed with the help of Python program. So next is Python program executing C++ program containing functions. So here also it will be the same. Okay, you can see that the whole entire C++ program is converted into arguments, and you can find this argument is parsed by using the for loop, and the for loop value containing O will be executed by using OS system.executable file, and you can see that is initiated by using this last statement. So you can get the output of it. And you can see the same example with inheritance. Okay, inheritance means getting the property of a super class into the base class. So from all these examples, one can understand the Python script used for integrating C++ in common. Only the name of the Python script file and the C++ file have changed. Remember, it is not mandatory to type C++ code if one computer contains already C++ file. In this chapter, to show all the types of C++ program like normal functions, inheritance program, it can be executed through Python, the code of C++ is explicitly mentioned, which means explicitly means it is created apart from the C Python program and saved as a separate file. So that is explicit. Implicit means the C++ program will be stored as a Python file itself inside the Python program. So using this, the Python script can even compile and execute C program also. So with this method, you can also not only you can execute C++ program, but also C program also. So since Python automates the C++ program files to execute without IDE, Python can be called as scripting language. Okay. So with this, we are finishing this chapter. We'll be seeing the new chapter today. In the next class. So here you can see that there are some book back exercise. I have already sent the full solution for the book back exercise. You can find it. If you're having any doubts, you can ask me. Okay, so thank you, students.